So how do we do radiometric calibration? Again, we are interested in this pipeline of going from L towards I, but we also want to be able to model the inverse phenomenon a bit. So let's start off with a color chart that we know the reflectances of. What basically means is a color chart like this comes in predefined, and here basically just I'm showing you the gray values here. It shows what are the intensities, 90, 59.1%. So somebody has sat down and calibrated this color chart as a perfect color model or grayscale values that we're interested in. What we want to do is we want to take multiple exposures from this color chart, which basically means is I'm going to take images of this. What I can do, of course, is I can take them at different exposure values. That basically means I can, you know, do things like epsilon photography. I can take images at different exposures, shutter speeds, and all that kind of stuff. That would, of course, change what kind of intensities for the same image that is out there. Of course, we're basically playing around on this parameter here, different types of parameters to get to this value. I'm just showing you an example of this. So again, my pixel values go from 0 to 255. This is my scene irradiance. I'm going to look at irradiance because we know scene radiance to irradiance is a linear thing, and actually we are more interested in trying to get there. This mapping is something which is linear. Of course, when done, we know what's going on. Of course, this basically means is now everything's projected on a 2D surface, which is the information is coming from. So of course, if I know the scene irradiance, I can plot a point as I go at different scene irradiance. And of course, I can figure out from this one, what is the intensity at each and every pixel. So next part that we can do now, of course, is after I've drawn this curve for a specific device or a sensor, an imaging device like the camera, I've done this on by taking, in this case, one image, two image, three, four, five, six, seven images, and I can basically fill in the curve. Now I can do the opposite, right? If I know a pixel value or I'm curious about a pixel value, can I actually now compute the scene irradiance? And that's what this exercise basically shows. Once I can model this, I can always come back and I say, okay, what's here? I can figure out the scene irradiance at this point. Again, scene irradiance here is going from 0 to 1. Now this will allow me to pick up any values I want. So, of course, there are a few assumptions here in when we play around with images like this. It assumes constant lighting, and all patches basically are equally well lit, so it can't be a focused light source. It assumes the light source is really far away and is equally lighting the whole scene. So, you know, for example, something like natural sunlight, when you light it with this kind of stuff, will allow you to do this. A unique inverse exists for G because, in this case, G is monotonic and smooth for all types of cameras, and again, we will model this for different cameras, and this allows us to compute this.